Well, I'm out there making it another great day. And today, I thought I would, it's like, what am I gonna do today? Yesterday, I had some bad luck. For some odd reason, I got a brand new phone and the navigational directions quit working. I couldn't search anything online. Couldn't figure it out. So I kind of went home empty-handed yesterday. And so here I'm out again today. Got that problem fixed. Just little things sometimes frustrate you, but you always have to come up with another option, another plan. So I thought, I think I'm going to go check out Tarpon Springs. There's some unique shops over here, and I found one called Bear Haven Vintage Toys. And I'm like, I got to go in here and check this out. So let's go now and check out Bear Haven Vintage Toys, and that's coming at you right now. Well, I am in downtown Tarpon Springs, just kind of checking out some shops. Some people kind of reluctant for me to do any video. Gonna walk in here. I don't know if I have any luck here, but this is a vintage toy store, and they got a guy out here. It is St. Patrick's Day when I'm shooting this, but he's serving up some toys. I'm gonna check some stuff out and see what I can get into in here. Well, this is Bear Haven Vintage Toys right here in Tarpon Springs on the main street. We're gonna go inside and check this out. And what's greeting us when we come in the door? C-3PO, and he is ready for, he's ready for Easter, it does look like. Well, it does look like Mickey Mouse, along with the Coca-Cola bear, is heckin' a little ride on this hobby horse, this carousel horse. It's a thoroughbred called Gone Country, the Sleek. And he's being a pirate on top of a horse. How interesting is that? I see some cool stuff here on the wall. There is a wrestler's trunks over here. I'm not sure which wrestler it's from, but they have some signed checks and things. Here we got a signed check from for the Wizard of Oz to Jack Haley. And this one here is from Gone with the Wind. And I'm sure that money's gone by now. And it was only $17.29. Some interesting statues here of people on benches and things, and they got a little pool hall going on down here, which looks pretty cool, a little display. They even have a signed animation sale here from Bill Hanna and Joe Barbera. It's, I think that's from a pup called Scooby-Doo. Didn't really watch that one. I watched the original Scooby-Doo. And we have been to places that had vintage cash registers. I have found another quite old cash register here in this shop. And yes, it's for sale. And it does work, it says. They have a lot of vintage, original, metal lunchboxes here. And they have a few left. They have a Superman. That's pretty cool. And Annie Oakley. I was looking for Dukes of Hazzard, but he said he already sold that for like $30 today, not recently. I am just finding so much stuff here. Here I have found an old Mickey Mouse. It's called the Wall Walker. I think I remember having this. It walks up down the walls and windows. And how cool is that? That is some vintage, vintage stuff, and it's made by Kenner. They do have the Pee-wee Herman doll here that talks. I'm not sure if I want to hear Pee-wee talk, but over here I discovered, does anybody know what this one is? I do. As soon as I saw it, it's the old Charlie McCarthy doll. Got the owner here, and he has shown me a Howdy Doody Marinette in the original box. How cool is this? He's going to open it up and show it to us, and that is darn cool if I do say so myself. And oh wow, that's probably one of the older one of the older things here in this shop. And here's the old camper on this metal vehicle here. And the owner here tells me this is probably the oldest item he has here from, I think, 1930. This wagon register. They have the vintage Fisher Price family farm set, and it is complete. And that's pretty darn cool. I remember having that when I was a kid, and they have the boat, and they have a family camper there as well. And if you want the whole Fisher-Price town, along with a school bus, they have that here too. It's a Main Street playset. And they have a small selection of electric guitars and regular guitars here in this shop. I'm not sure how it fits in with toys, but it could be a toy for big boys. And they do have a bunch of vintage baseball cards here. Some of those rookie cards, I remember collecting those of them today. There's Ken Griffey Jr. I remember having his rookie card, and God, that is so long ago. And I do believe that might be his rookie card. I'm not sure. It's way, way back. But they do have a bunch. Here's a Johnny Bench. And that's from 1982. So many baseball cards, and they even have them in the wax boxes down here still, that you can buy a whole box of these from way back in the day. Here I know this card of Ken Griffey Jr., and I know that is his rookie card. I have spotted it. I had that at one time. That's an Upper Deck card, and he's got $50 on it, and that was a long time ago. I kind of remember this thing. It's called Robotics Robodog. Construction system. Anybody out there remember this here thing? It does sound familiar. It seems like I remember that, but it's been a long time. And they have a full table of Star Wars vintage toys made back when they originally came out. They do have some in the boxes, and these are out of the box, of course. Here's the Millennium Falcon and original. Pretty cool. Well, I have found C-3PO. It's an interactive robotic droid, and it's a pretty good size, and these were exclusive only at, of all places are going out of business, Toys R Us. I do like this one right here, the TIE Fighter. How many remember Teddy Rubskin? They have the Teddy Rubskin here, original, with the cassette. They have a bunch of board games here, and I found one. Remember the show ALF? Anybody know that ALF had a board game called the ALF game? I don't think I remember that one. I remember the Dukes of Hazzard board game. I have it. There's one called Easy Money. Everybody remembers Hangman, I'm sure. And the old classic Dominoes. Not only do they have a bunch of vintage Star Wars stuff, but they have some vintage Barbies here. And a lot of different collectible Barbie dolls and all kinds of dolls in this shop. Unbelievable how much stuff is in here. They even have Barbie and Ken. Remember that time they performed on the Grand Ole Opry? And yeah, me, I don't either. Even Barbie and Ken have got into the Star Trek Enterprise here. It does look like they have invaded the Enterprise. Pretty cool. And there's Lieutenant Uhura. There's a Barbie of her. Well, I have found another classic. And these look like originals in the box here. This Star Trek vinyl figure. And I do believe it is it says AMT Ertl made this. It's a model kit. Actually, I guess you put that together as a model kit, plastic model. And they also have a war on models over here, as you can tell, with all these tanks and military jets and things that. The old model kits. How many remember model kits out there? I have found something here that's caught my eye. The Batmobile from 1960s Batmobile. And it's a plastic model kit. This is an old original, looks like. They even have a game here called Reminiscing. The game for people over 30. Oh, how cool is that? That's what I'm doing here today in this little shop is reminiscing. And you know why all those little girls out there want to be Barbie. I mean, she's got everything. Look at that. She's got a Porsche. Unbelievable. Here's a little bit of a wider shot of Bear Haven vintage toys right here in Tarpon Springs. And they have so much stuff in here to look at. If you're a collector and you like to collect vintage toys of all different types, this is the place to come next time you come to Florida for a visit. Well, I am in the back in the warehouse here at Bear Haven Vintage Toys. And they have some Halloween mannequins back here. The guy back there, he looks pretty cool. And I guess they put these out closer to the holidays. This one here, he's got a little hat going on. I'm not sure what he's doing. He kind of looks like something from the Ride the Mummy there, for sure. This right here is a Halloween Haven for sure. This is the Bear Haven Vintage Toys. And this guy here is kind of mummified. There's a whole bunch of mummies here. And creepy things. Here's a mummy up on the side of the wall here. they have a lot of Star Wars stuff back here on the shelves. I mean, so much stuff. A lot of the newer stuff. But as I pan around here in this is his warehouse, and let me back in here in the warehouse. They have, these are original. Here's a Rebel Transport, which is an original in the original box. I don't think it's even been opened. And pretty cool. Here's the Imperial Shuttle down here. Lots of original Star Wars collectibles here. I've seen these at other shops, but these are in pretty good condition in these boxes. I'm not sure how well you can see this big ship up here, but look how huge that is setting up there, and I'm assuming he uses that for one of his window displays or something. He's got stuff packed away in boxes back here. He said a lot of the vintage stuff is stuff he's collected over the years for his family, and he just decided to open up this shop, and a lot of old vintage toys and stuff, a lot of Star Wars stuff. Here is, they have some very old railroad sets and slot car racing sets, and that one here is called Ford Apache Stockade. That is an ancient box for sure right there on that one. I don't even think I've ever seen that one before. They even have guitars here and amplifiers and the old Fender stuff, some vintage stuff. And they have a bunch of trains, old vintage trains and stuff. Here's some farm equipment. And here's a logging truck. That logging truck's pretty darn cool. And it's back here in the warehouse. And they do have a lot of baseball memorabilia in this shop. Here is Lou Gehrig. And it's got his autograph on this placard. Looks like they even have an autograph of Shaq back here from his Orlando Magic days. They have some nice vintage Beatles animation cells back here. On the wall, there's one of them, and there's another one right below it. And I find those very, very nice, very cool. And they have some vintage G.I. Joes here, and not in the box. That one's in a bag, but vintage original G.I. Joes. And I found one here that is in the box, and he's called Duke, and it's a Hall of Fame G.I. Joe. Some classic toys here in this shop for sure to bring back some great memories. We're going to take a quick walk through here before we leave. As you see all the figures over there on the wall, there's the owner right there helping a customer. There's some people coming in here. You kind of walk around and show you a little bit all the baseball cards here in the case. All kinds of collectibles everywhere in this shop. I'm just absolutely blown away at this vintage toy shop. And some of it is from his own personal collection of his family over the years. And he has brought it out here and decided to open up a retail shop and sell toys. And pretty incredible of all the stuff in this little shop in the little town of Tarpon Springs. Well, that was Bear Haven Vintage Toys right here in Tarpon Springs. And I'm just wandering around here today, checking out some of these places. And I was glad I stopped into Bear Haven Vintage Toys. A lot of people was coming in there. I never seen so much stuff. It's right by a place I did a video at before called Replay Museum. So that's pretty darn cool, the stuff you can find in a little town like Tarpon Springs. And I'm going to go check out more stuff here today. And I appreciate you watching. Hope you enjoyed going down memory lane, seeing some of these old toys. The owner here, super nice. I really appreciate his time and all his information that he gave me about the toys that he had inside this shop. And it's just love going and looking in places like this and the stuff you find when you do go in these kind of places. I appreciate all you subscribers out there hitting that subscribe button. Hope we're taking you to places you want to see. Some places I want to check out, you know, and I'm glad I did. And Tarpon Springs is a great little place to come down and check out some antique shops, the vintage toy shop, the Replay Museum, all kinds of places to eat, all kinds of stuff to do down here on an afternoon, on a weekend, on a Saturday, or even during the week. So I'm going to keep going out there making it a great day as best as I possibly can. Every day you can't always do that. You get a little depressed sometimes, and you just have to come up with another option sometimes. But again, We'll see you here another time, and remember, go out there, make it a great day, because you deserve it.